The 2002 Declaration on the Conduct of Parties in the South China Sea was a diplomatic initiative of a special significance and a milestone in the history of China-ASEAN relations, as well as an endeavor in the history of contemporary international relations that's demonstrating collective wisdom and creativity. The declaration was a product of China and ASEAN's ability to manage differences through institutions and rulesmaking independently without any external intervention. Chinese State Council and Foreign Minister Wang Yi have made remarks when addressing the opening ceremony of seminar commemorating the 20th anniversary of DOC signing in the Beijing. Several maritime cooperation products have been achieved throughout the years. China-ASEAN Joint Maritime Search and Rescue Tabletop Exercise was held in Guangdong on September 27, 2016 to promote the pragmatic cooperation between China and the ASEAN countries in the field of maritime search and rescue. Afterwards, China and ASEAN launched the first China-ASEAN combined maritime search and rescue field exercise in Zhenjiang, Guangdong on October 31, 2017. Moreover, China and ASEAN also conducted two joint military drills in 2018 and 2019, respectively. The Code of Conduct negotiation had also achieved significant progress in recent years. In May 2017, the 14th official meeting was held in Guiyang to review and approve the COC's draft framework. In the China-ASEAN joint communique on how the dispute should be characterized, the ASEAN foreign minister mentioned that they were encouraged by the adoption of the framework, which would facilitate the work for the conclusion of an effective COC on a mutually agreed timeline. On August 3, 2018, the foreign minister of the 10 ASEAN member states and China announced that they have adopted single draft negotiating text. The text sheds light on the initial positions of the negotiating party. At the East China Summit, Chinese Premier Li Keqiang proposed the vision of completing the COC consultation within 3 years, which means we will be able to vision a code of conduct within year 2021. Through the first reading, the text is streamlined so the framework and essential elements of the COC become clearer and the structure become more reasonable. It marks new and major progress in COC consultation and an important step towards the goal of concluding the consultation within 3 years. As COVID-19 pandemic was wreaking havoc, it also slowed the negotiation process since 2020. Despite the impact of epidemic, China and ASEAN countries remained committed to the full and effective implementation of 2002 DOC and maintaining the negotiation on the code of conduct through virtual meetings. On November 10th and 11th, 2021, China and ASEAN countries held the 34th Joint Working Group meeting on the implementation of the DOC in the South China Sea. In addition, on June 7th, the 19th senior official meetings on the implementation of the DOC in the South China Sea between China and ASEAN countries was held official in Chongqing. From May 25th to 27th, 2022, China and ASEAN countries held the 36th Joint Working Group meeting on the implementation of the Declaration on the Conduct of Parties in the South China Sea in Siem Reap, Cambodia. This was the first face-to-face working group meeting between the parties since the pandemic outbreak. The United States has been keenly observing the development in the South China Sea, especially the negotiation of the Code of Conduct, even though it only involves China and 10 ASEAN member states. In 2010, when Hillary Clinton, the Secretary of the State, attending the East Asia Summit in Hanoi, called a legally binding Code of Conduct for South China Sea. The USA has been urging China and ASEAN countries to reach the COC as early as possible on various multilateral and bilateral occasions. In 2014, President Obama also expressed the COC is also important to the US national interest in the South China Sea during his visits to Japan, South Korea, Philippines, and Malaysia. Yet the position of the USA seems to change in the past few years. Instead of calling the early conclusion of the CSC, it now turns to stress third-party concern, calling for the transparency of the negotiation, trying to exert its influence over the negotiations process by various means. During the East Asia Summit and the Foreign Ministry meeting in August 2019, U.S. Secretary of State Pompeo stressed the U.S. position on the South China Sea during the talks with the foreign minister, saying that no state should put pressure on others during the negotiation and the third-party concern should be included as part of the COC. On July 13, 2020, the Secretary of State Mike Pompeo issued a statement outlining the U.S. position on the maritime claims in the South China Sea. Pompeo's announcement explicitly endorsed the 2016 arbitration ruling that urged Southeast Asian countries to stand up to China. On May 15, 2022, U.S. President Joe Biden hosted the first in-person U.S.-ASEAN leaders summit at the White House since the pandemic started. The joint statement called for an early conclusion of a code of conduct in the South China Sea consistent with the UN clause. The COC is supposed to be a set of rules outlining the norm, responsibilities, and restrictions of the negotiator. It will be an outcome of the actual needs of the South China Sea region. It will play a vital role in regulating the behavior of all parties, maintaining navigation safety and freedom of the navigation in the South China Sea. But it is not the way US sees it. The US worries that a successful conclusion of the COC will greatly increase China's influence in the region, which will pose a challenge to the US national interest. But regional countries speculate for an effective COC to be reached in the near future. Cambodian Minister of Foreign Affairs Prang Suk Hom quoted, "I have to say that it is the aspiration of every ASEAN member state to conclude the COC as early as possible." This year, we celebrate the 20th anniversary of the Declaration on the Conduct of the Parties in the South China Sea, which was adopted in Cambodia 20 years ago. If we can conclude the COC this year, it will have a positive impact not only for Cambodia, of course, but also for the whole region. At present, China and ASEAN countries are at the crossroads of COC consultation, facing the risk of backsliding if negotiations are stalled for too long. Article 10 of the Declaration has made the adoption of COC a clear and ultimate goal. In fact, neither the DOC nor the COC is a platform for resolving disputes in the South China Sea. Any attempt to raise a negotiation price is intended to prevent or destroy consultation. The negotiation requires the political will of the Chinese and ASEAN countries as the cornerstone. It will also require the support and encouragement for the extra-region country to provide a stable external political environment, mainly the United States.
China is a big power and should assume greater responsibility in maintaining peace and stability in the region. While China is also a sovereign state and needs to be treated as an equal. What a negotiation means compromise, which is a two-way rather than one-sided process. Demanding too much on China is not the way to be good neighbor and friend, nor does it serve the interest of all parties as well as the whole region.
What should always be kept in mind is that Article 10 of the Declaration has already said 20 years ago the conclusion of COC as a long-term goal. This is also the common wish and the commitment of China and the 10 ASEAN countries. The road ahead will be long and our climb will be steep.